Welcome to Secret of Evermore. Sorry if I sound a little bit out of it. I'm actually just getting over a head cold, like plugged nasal passageways, sore throat, and a couple of other things. Not really a lot, but something, you know, just talking winded me. Oh, excuse me. There's a lot of hate for this game. I think it's subsided a little bit considering its age, but, a lot of people consider this, you know, when it came out, the successor of Secret of Mana. However, it's not. It's really not. More on, there's a bunch of problems. This game kind of has a, I guess you would want to call it a tragic development. I mean, a lot of people thought this was the sequel for Secret of Mana when it came out. It's not. The people who developed Secret of Mana were not the ones who developed this one. Even though it's still the Squaresoft title, it was two entirely different teams. The ones who developed this game were based in the US, and it was their first game. So you gotta give a little bit of, you know, okay, it's their first game, I understand. Also, you know, everything was dictated by the main office. You know, the game is supposed to be basically based off of cheesy B-movies. I actually know more about the history than I do about the game. Haha! Granted, I own this game and I've beaten it a couple times. It's not a great game, but it's not a bad game. It's a decent game. It's not, you know, another Chrono Trigger. It's not another Final Fantasy VI. It's not another, you know, Super Mario RPG. It's not in that territory. Actually, the release date for this was, what, sometime in 95? I think it was in October. And Chrono Trigger came out in the end of August of that year, so a lot of people weren't paying attention to this. Also, late 94 was when Final Fantasy VI came out. So this was overlooked by a lot of people. And also that the game was limited to 12 megabits, which for the game size, so it was cut down quite a bit from what Secret of Mana was, what some things cut out that people were really upset about, which I understand. More on that later. And right at the end of development, they doubled it to 24 megabits. And they tried to fill it, and, well, didn't... What they used to fill it, they didn't really balance correctly, I think is the best way to put it. So pretty much, the team from USA got everything dictated to them, and kind of got the jerk around. I mean, kind of, you know, what they could have done isn't what happened. You know, and it was their first game, so, yeah. A mummy, a chainsaw, and a balloon animal. This is 30 years later, and the balloon is still inflated? It's kind of amazing. And we know where this is. So yeah, kind of a tragic story. It connects to this, and the boy is going to say a whole lot about cheesy movies. I don't even know if they're real movies. I don't think they are. I think they're made-up movies. He almost speaks in B-movie. Because the whole game is based on cheesy B-movies. The whole dialogue, and a lot of people didn't like that, but, you know, when you know that. I'm trying to defend this game, but at the same time, I know it's not as good as it should have been. I mean, it's not a bad game. I like this game. I mean, it's no, E.T. for the Atari. It's no, I'm trying to think of other bad games off the top of my head. It's no Isle of the Dead, either. No, I still can't believe I did that game. I really wish I didn't. But, it's not a great game, but it's not a bad game. It's a decent game. It's playable. Come along, come along. And, well, more discussion on, you know, the whole data thing and why that's important to why people hate this game. That'll come in a bit. After you, although you're not going to follow me, so that's a little bit strange. Again, I'm sorry, did I mention this? Kind of getting over a head cold, so, yeah. Anyway, Bazooka. Oh, we're starting this game off really, really well. Just started the game and got a bazooka. These guys don't give experience. I don't really think they can do much damage either. Hell, I dodged. Nope, wrong button. It's B. Not Y. Y is the menu. And that's it. That's our first fight. They're not worth anything. There's no money, no experience, no nothing. Is that you, buddy? I can't see very well. It's dark in here. Hey! Okay, I'm gonna stop that. There goes the control pad. No, mine's actually working fine. I'm actually using an analog stick, though. I should find my other controller that has a D-pad. I really should. I don't know where I put it. Like, I wrapped it up, put it away, and I can't find it. I always have this problem, too. I can never find things that I actually need. That was some landing, and the bazooka's gone. The thing about the bazooka, though, is it's actually not that good. Like, really, like, later in the game, as you get weapons, and then eventually you come across the bazooka once again, it's really not that good. More on that later, when it happens, if it happens. And, my dog's changed a bit. Kind of a prehistoric feral wolf thing going on. If you're really my dog, you'll fetch the stick. And, well, that's not the stick, but it's fine. Now, the thing about the data. Paddle, that's a healing item, it's like 40. The thing about the data, if you played Secret of Mana and or you know about it, you'll know you can play it with multiple players. But the thing is, well, if you're playing an RPG, multiple players, that's kind of weird in my opinion. But this game didn't have that. Since there was very limited space, that was one of the first things they cut out, and it was so late in development that I think when the 24 megabits hit, that they couldn't fix it. And they added other stuff instead. But yeah, you'll notice the dog is sniffing around. The dog can actually find, like, various hidden items. Like those roots. You can force him to do it with the, shoulder buttons. And actually, if you hit select button, you can control the dog. But at this point, the dog is ridiculously slow. So you want to stay in control of the boy most of the time. The dog is usually much more physically able. Like, outclasses the boy in every single way, as far as, you know, physical stuff goes. However, the boy has things that kind of compensate for that quite a bit. Mosquitoes are really hard to hit. However, I really would like him to come back. The stuff over here. There's lots of hidden stuff. Sometimes it's useful, sometimes it's not. Most of the stuff I'm getting is ingredients for things later. Now, that was dumb. I really don't want to use that pedal I picked up earlier, either. I want to keep that. And you're not going to do full damage unless you have, 100%. Yeah, and I think it makes the mosquitoes easier to hit. That might be, I believe the, No. Yeah, useful for mangling mosquitoes. I think it actually has a better chance of hitting. Why am I in control of the dog? That's silly. Controlling the dog is foolish. Can't go this way, because there's grass in our way. I'm assuming the boy won't walk through it because he's afraid of ticks. Which I can completely understand. No prehistoric ticks. There's something right there. Something right there. Yeah, I've played the intro to this a couple of times in the recent past. right now, enemies are really easy. I'm just failing miserably because I'm talking. Something right here, and right here. Yeah, don't expect me to keep that up for the rest of the game. No, 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 no. And he's dead. Pick that up, some oil, which is nice. Some water. Again, that this'll all become important later. Not so much right now. Ugh. Come back, Mr. Mosquito. I believe they drop healing items. There we go. Some ash. Again, it'll be useful later. Also, you notice, probably have noticed, there's no music. Ugh, excuse me. There's no music right now? The strange thing is there's really not a lot of music in this game. A lot of it's, you know, background noises, like right now, jungle noises. But the music that is in this game tends to be pretty damn amazing. Could you not hit my dog? That's not appreciated. Thank you. These guys can only attack in cardinal directions, and Enzo has reached level 2. I'm not stopping at 2. Because there is a fight coming up that if you win it, you get a whole bunch of bonus stuff. However, you can lose it and continue the game. However, I do want the stuff, so I'm going to have to do a little bit of grinding. And I hate mosquitoes. That and leveling the dog would be quite nice, considering how hard the dog will eventually hit. Now, if I walk forward, I'm going to get in that aforementioned fight, but let's not do that. Let's go back. Everything's respawned. Thinking level 4 or so? Also, very satisfying squish noise. I think so, at least. But getting a couple levels is going to be a huge help. Mostly because of defense and all that, considering I don't have any armor on right now. Dog reaches level 2. That's a nice help. 8. Never get everything on one trip through. Anyway, I'm going to cut to when I am done with that. I'm going to keep recording just in case something nifty happens, which is rather unlikely. But, I'll meet you back. Squish. Also, thing I failed to mention, the dog requires more experience than the boy to level. Not that it's really that important. Not to mention, doing this will also give me extra money, which will eventually become very useful. Oh, I missed something. Water. Clay. Yeah, it's rather exacting. This is annoying. Damn it! It's here somewhere. Oh, okay. Oh, there we go. Roots. Alright. Nah, that's not what I want. What I want is the petals. Herbal Essence, I think, just cures status ailments. But, I'm actually not getting many healing items. This kind of stinks. I just have that one petal. Also, my dog needs to level in the near future. Also, I find it kind of amazing I can even hit a mosquito with a femur. A human femur. Most likely, too, at that. It's kind of morbid, isn't it? No, oh, I missed some water. Ugh. Did I mention there was a patch hack of this game that makes it two-player? A little glitchy, but does. Yeah. Oh. That Bone Crusher level 2. I can't believe I've been here that long. Yeah. Where are you going? Anyway, you hold the attack button. Charges up. And, assuming I can show it in the near future. Yeah, he's gonna kill that. Next! Yeah, a little bit more damage. Only goes up to level... two levels of charge, other than, you know, that percentage one up to a normal hit. I think Sacred Mana was like 9? That's ridiculous. And... that mosquito was being very silly. It's actually going to make this fight coming up a lot harder, easier. Assuming I can connect with it. That's the second problem. However, I still would like some more petals. The game hasn't really given me any. I think it hates me today. It's funny, because when I was playing this earlier, I filled right up. Like in no time. Hey, finally! I was only going to get up to 4, but the game wouldn't give me my 4th petal, and I just got it recently. So, yeah, you don't need to do that grinding. I chose to do it because, well, yeah, it'll make this easier. We get ambushed. I have a strange feeling about this. Now we're fighting raptors. Nope. Crap. Yeah, that's the problem with charging. If you miss. Oh wow, you got brutally murdered. This won't be so bad, I don't think. No, definitely not. There's only 4 of them. First 3 have 40 HP. First 3. And the last one has 80, I believe. Come here. In a way that doesn't hit me, I'm not even gonna need those petals, am I? Yeah, you're definitely the one that has, more HP. Come on. Gotcha. That was almost too easy. It's the whole level 5 thing. If you're level 4, it's still kind of dangerous. At level 5, it's almost a joke. Level 4, you need petals. Level 5, you don't. Also, make sure we pick these things up. Also, having the charge for my weapon helps a great deal. Come on. Yeah, this is another problem. The whole finding items thing. There we go. Crystals? This early? Huh. Any more? Come on, puppy. Also, I need to change something. Act. Since you can manually make your dog search, you might as well just put him on that. You really should. Put him on aggressive, that is. Anyway, that takes care of that. With all those things dead, I'm going to get my bonuses. 50 talents, which is money, and 1 petal, which is healing, and there's 1 more item that you get in a bonus. However, I need to fight it. It's in one of the huts. You talk to some dude and he gives you things, and I'm going to steal this lady's things. Also, I need to change the border. I don't like it. Yeah, let's go with that. At least for a little while. Pilfering things. Time-honored RPG tradition. Break into someone's house, steal their stuff! But yeah, I can't even check currently what stuff I have until later. But the game does keep track of it. And the stuff I am picking up will do something. Strongheart and the Bugmuck. Alchemy. Yeah, alchemy is pretty much the magic of this game. 18 talents. Talents is money. I actually got quite a bit of talents from drops, other than, you know, the ones they initially give you. Like, for killing them, they sometimes drop extra money. It's only like 5, so I picked up like a whole 15, maybe 20. But But also this hut, if you lose to those guys, you actually appear in this screen because the dog grabs the boy and drags him off. No, I'm good. 605. That's actually pretty decent. It's kind of silly considering the dog can sniff out items inside of a thing. Inside of a gourd. Or later on, any number of things. Hello! Ah, Grass Fest. This is another one of those things we get for free. Just basic armor. It's the weakest armor in the game, but, you know, it's free. Just for spending a little bit more time grinding. So I think there's something right up here. Stuff right here. No, I haven't played this game much. No, not at all. Also, secret area. Biscuit revives the dog. If the dog perishes, reaches 0 HP, you can use a biscuit to revive him. I think it's 100 HP it heals him. If the boy reaches 108, it reaches 0 HP, you die. Well, I don't need to buy the grass vest. That saved me 120 talons. The dog gets colors, one per world in the game. You can buy them or wait and get it for free. I'm gonna do that. I don't normally, but I'm going to. Yeah, the wheel thing is also like Secret of Evermore. They basically took the engine and made another game out of it. Could you please move, neon bearded caveman? Alrighty, what's in here? Basically, I am just pilfering the town for things. As you should. But, we need to talk to the leader of this town, of this lovely little village. Yeah, pretty much everybody in this town is talking about alchemy. It is important. Hey, buddy! I guess the dog just falls asleep. He's like, I'm a dog, I don't have to give anybody respect. Doesn't feed me, I don't care. It's like a cult over here. Oh, hi. Enzo is my name. Smashing Monsters is my game. Actually, that's my dog. He hasn't been himself lately. That line repeats so many times in this game. His name, it's... Yeah, if you don't know who Enzo is, maybe this will clarify it for you. If it doesn't, I'll explain. No? Frisket. Enzo and Frisket are characters in the series called Reboot. Nice series when I was a kid. I'm actually watching it again. I'm like, I posted it on Facebook. It's like, name for a thing, dog, a boy and his dog. And I'm actually kind of upset at myself that I couldn't think of that combination. I mean, I wasn't going to go and do the whole Wallace and Gromit thing because it's been overused a bajillion times. That would be helpful. It would make the game very short. Earn or keep, wow. The new fella? Alright. Ours needs slumberjacks. I'm ready for anything. Yeah, again, lots of B-movies. He's going to be mentioning this a lot. He doesn't even really have his own dialogue. It's like, all he does is reference B-movies. And that's our first alchemy spell. This game actually starts out pretty hard. Considering, you know, when you enter and you get one petal out of one of the gourds, and that's pretty much it, if you're unlucky. And you don't get any from monsters, that's all you have to fight the raptors if you go straight there. So beating them at level 2 is pretty difficult. I'm not saying it's possible, I'm just saying it's hard. Yeah, the more you use it, the better it gets. It requires what? 1 ash and 2 oil? Yeah, and there's no healing spell for a while either. That's another drawback. Doesn't give you one very quickly. I need to find the alchemist guy. I've got 13 ash. Let's buy a little bit of oil. I already have 25 water. That's pretty intense. But, yeah, that pretty much fills me out for that. I should have, 2. Did I buy the wrong thing? Remember how to control this game. The wheel thing, and half the time I know exactly what I'm doing, the other half it's like, what am I doing? Oh, it's wax. Well, crap. Also, you can't sell them back. Which kind of stinks. I guess I could theoretically go this way and farm up some money, but that's a little tedious to do it that way. I'd rather fight stronger things and buy it later. But that's enough for this part. Next time we'll, I think it's right over this way. Yeah, we'll go that way. So I'm fully armored for what's here. My dog will get his for free later. And I bought the wrong alchemy ingredients. Oh well, it happens. Until then, where are you going? Thought I already picked that up. Meh, anyway, until next time.